Hey, dads. Does your son or daughter love to do mazes? Our son is like obsessed with mazes, so I figured that I would talk to you guys about a gift that he got for Christmas that he's really excited about. And honestly, as a dad, I kind of had some fun with it too. First of all, hi to all the new dads out there. This is Dad Reviews. This is where I give you my unedited, hopefully more authentic review of the products that I like, use, and have. So if you're into that, you might want to consider clicking that subscribe button. Also, that thumbs up button is appreciated. And today we have this this ball, and it's this. It's called a Perplexus, and it's basically a maze in a ball. And there is a There it is. Okay, so you have this little steel ball in there, and you start it off, and there's like a little start tray, if you will. And you roll it up, and then you have to go through the entire maze, turning the ball in the correct direction so that you can go throughout the maze. My son has been having so much fun with this. He loves doing mazes. And honestly, whenever I was his age, I was big into mazes. I love to draw mazes. I love to do mazes. And this is just like the next evolution of mazes. I think it's so cool. But basically, it's a 3D maze is what it is. Now that I think about it, you know, most of them are all 2D mazes, being like on paper or even like on a computer, you know, you drag the thing. But this is a 3D maze. So we first got notice of this because we got a Christmas catalog, and my son saw this cube that was a maze, and you kind of turn it different which ways. But a friend told us about the Perplexus, and we just thought that it was so much more cooler. So we decided to get that for him for Christmas, and it's just, it's a fun toy. Now, I gotta say, one caveat here, being Dad Reviews, we're giving you this authentic stuff. We have two of them. The reason is because my daughter got frustrated doing the maze, and she slammed it down. And that caused, see these little gray bars right here? There's one right there, and it's connected to the yellow piece in there that holds the thing together. One of them, whenever she slammed it down, came out of the yellow part there, and it off-centered the maze a little bit, and so now the ball couldn't go through. It was right here. It couldn't go through underneath this tunnel part here on the maze. So you literally, like, couldn't do the maze. So being a dad, I'm like, okay, let me see if I can fix this thing, see if we can get it back to working, see if I can get that little gray piece right back in there. So, I started to get a knife right there. You can see how it's a little torn up, and I tried to pry it open so that I could get into there. I couldn't pry it open, so I tried it from this side, just trying to like push it down in to hopefully move the gray piece in. And then I got a knife, and I was trying to push it in, and it just slid through, and I made a big giant crack on there. Now I was able to get it back in, and I put a piece of clear tape on it, so the ball still is functional. It just has a little blemish on there now, if you will. So since our daughter did that to our son's gift, we made her have to buy him a new one. So we actually have two of these things now. And they do make, this is the rookie. They do make more advanced mazes. There's actually one spot in here that's really, really tough. It took me a good like 12 hours, probably a little bit longer, to figure out how to do the one particular. I think it's, each piece is numbered, so you know which number you stopped at. And I think it was like number 30 or 31 or something like that. I just kept getting stuck on this certain spot. Then I figured it out. And after I did that, I was able to fly through the rest of it. But my son still hasn't completed the maze, so it's still a big challenge for him. He's had it for a few weeks now, and he still plays with it. Well, another thing that I really like about it too is whenever I watch him playing with it, he's like super concentrated on it. So it's a great way, a great quiet time activity if you need to have some quiet time. And it's also a great activity where he can focus on doing something, on a completion, on task. You know, just getting that art of focus instilled in him. And that's one thing that I really like about it. And then I also like how, like I said, there's more advanced ones, which I'll find all the different ones I can find. I'll link them up down in the description below. I think there's like 3 or 4 different advanced ones. But, as he gets older, he can get another one and he can try and do the more advanced ones. And I'll be excited about that too, because I'll be doing the more advanced ones as well. But super fun toy here. Definitely recommend it. If I was like giving toy awards, this would be like a top award toy for me. I think that this is just so neat. I think somebody really took the time to really think about, you know, what they're creating here. And I think it's a whole new way to look at doing mazes in a more 3D fashion as opposed to something more 2D. So from a dad perspective, I really like this product right here. Again, if you guys wanna check them out, I'll link them up down in the description below. If you guys are liking the dad reviews here, make sure to click more of our videos if you wanna watch more of the dad reviews. Also, I'd love it if you click that subscribe button right there in the middle if you want to get future videos. Thank you guys for watching. If there's a product that you want me to try out here on Dad Reviews, let me know what it is down in the comments below and I'll see if I can get it for you. Again, thank you for watching and Dad out.